Mike and Maurice's Mind Escape presents The Origins of Ancient Greece. The islet of Daskalio in Greece, also known as the Pyramid Island. It is located off the coast of Caros Island in the Cyclades. Cyclades translates into encircling islands, and they get their name for encircling the sacred island of Delos. Daskalio was inhabited and used from roughly 2750 to 2300 BC during ancient Greece's early Bronze Age. It was a maritime sanctuary that is connected to the larger archaeological site of Caros. At one point, the water levels were lower, and there might have been a land bridge between Caros and Daskalio. It was definitely a hub for metallurgy and trade. The evidence suggests an advanced civilization for the time that included engineering, political organization, and shipbuilding. This site may have been the origin of Hellenic civilization. The ancient people that lived there made large terraces which were meant to intentionally accentuate the pyramid-like shape. These people may have been influenced by ancient Egyptian pyramid builders. There is speculation that this site may have influenced the Minoan and the Mycenaean civilizations. The white marble found there was transported from the island of Naxos. It was most likely a religious site, where travelers would come and bury religious figurines of unknown gods as sacrifices. This archaeological site was made popular in the 1960s by Colin Renfrew and Christos Dumas. They discovered it had been looted. Dumas started to archaeologically investigate it in 1963. The Cambridge Caros Project is the name of the ongoing archaeological excavation program. This site is interesting to say the least. We will keep an eye on it and bring you any updates regarding any finds. The Dragon House at Mount Ochi. This site is very mysterious. There's no dating, suggested dating, information, or speculation on who the builders may have been. There are no references made in ancient texts or by historians. From 2002 to 2004, the Astrophysics Department of the University of Athens made connections to the star Sirius dating back to 1100 BC. With very little information on this site, we will have to keep an eye on this one as well. The Greek Pyramid of Hellenikon. There is controversy surrounding the dating of this structure. Mainstream archaeologists suggest it was built sometime between the 4th or 5th century BC as a tomb for the soldiers who fought for the throne of Argos. The thermoluminescence dating of the surface of the megalithic stones suggested a date of 2000 to 2500 BC. This would date it to roughly the time of the construction of the Great Pyramid of Giza. The ceramic shards that were found at the site were dated from 3000 to 200 BC. The entrance corridor of the pyramid was found to align with Orion's belt from 2000 to 2400 BC. Recently, a new method for dating stone was applied to the pyramid, and it suggested a date between the 4th and 3rd millennium BC. This was discredited by archaeologists. The Mycenaean sites of Mycenae and Tiryns. The Mycenaean period of ancient Greece was the last phase of its Bronze Age. It spanned from 1600 to 1100 BC. Mycenae was a major fixture of Greek civilization. It was the first advanced civilization of Greece's mainland. In 1350 BC, the citadel at Mycenae had a population of 30,000 people. Mycenae is an acropolis site at roughly 900 feet above sea level. There are traces of early Neolithic activity. In Greek mythology, Mycenae was founded by Perseus. Here's the foundation of the Megaron at Mycenae. Megaron was a great hall found in ancient Greek palace complexes. Grave Circle A is a 16th century BC royal grave site. As you can see below, the site has megalithic walls that were created using cyclopean masonry. In 1876, Heinrich Schliemann became the first person to excavate these sites. He was inspired by Homer's descriptions in the Iliad. Schliemann is probably most famous for finding the site of Troy. The Lion Gate. The Lion Gate is the main entrance to the citadel of Mycenae. It was built in 1250 BC. It is the only existing monumental Mycenaean sculpture. As you can see, the large megalithic walls were created using Cyclopean masonry. The lion sculpture resembles imagery found at Knossos, which was an ancient Minoan civilization site. Pictured here is the tomb of Clytemnestra. It is a Tholos-style tomb. It was built in 1250 BC for King Agamemnon's wife. Some have suggested that it was built for King Agamemnon himself. The triangular cutout above the doorway reminded me of the Lion Gate. It is possible that there was once a sculpture there as well that may have been similar to the Lion Gate or possibly something different. Here's a picture of the inside of the tomb, and as you can see, the triangular cutout goes all the way through to the interior. The golden years of Tiryns were from 1200 to 1400 BC. Tiryns displays cyclopean tunnels and masonry. Schliemann excavated the site, as well as other sites in the area. Here we have two examples of cyclopean tunnels found at Tiryns. Look at the massive stone structures. They are so crudely put together. It is amazing that they are still standing. And finally, here is a close-up example of cyclopean masonry found at Tiryns. Ancient traditions say that Cyclops built the cyclopean walls. Since he was a giant, he's the only one that could lift the stones. If you enjoyed this video and you want to learn more, check out our podcast episode, Ancient Greece Part 4, Megalithic Structures and Temples. Subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. If you enjoy these short movies and want us to make more, please leave a comment below.